Hi, I'm William Mills at Finovate Europe, and I'm joined today by Julian Sawyer, who's Chief Operating Officer of Starling Bank. Welcome, Julian. How are you doing today?
Very well, thank you. Very well.
Thank you for joining us. First, let's start off a little bit. Tell us about Starling Bank and your role at Starling Bank.
So I'm one of the co-founders of Starling Bank. We were formed in 2014. As one of the new generation or challenger banks in the UK. And our proposition is around a current account or check account on a mobile phone. So putting everything that you do on banking on one channel, on one device, and changing the market.
Cool. Well, as a mobile-only bank, how do you see the financial services transforming in a mobile world?
I think what you've got is you've got a product that you use many times a day, your current account, your debit card. And how many hundreds of times a day do we actually look at our mobile phone? So what we've done is we've put the right product on the right channel.
Right.
And we are focused on people who live their life on a mobile phone. Mm-hmm. That's not age related, it's about your mindset on technology.
Right.
And so we have a whole range of customers from 16 to 85 who are all using their account and just really transforming how financial services works in the UK by putting everything onto that mobile device and using all the assets that's got for us.
Well, this Wednesday you're hosting a discussion on building and using APIs, especially probably related to mobile. What opportunities do you see for financial institutions related to APIs?
Well, we think there's two main parts here. The first of all is we have a marketplace that has got a set of APIs where third parties, other companies, competitors, and also new technology companies, new fintechs, can write against those APIs and add value to our customers. And that could be in loyalty, it could be savings products, investments, insurance, etc.
Right.
And so what that does is provide to our customers more products, more features than they would get, because we are very focused. We are only doing one product, which is the current account on the mobile phone.
Right.
But consumers do want other products and other services. So using our APIs, we enable customers to engage with a whole raft of other providers. So that's our first use of APIs.
Okay.
Our second is our payments business. So Starling Banking Services is all about providing access to the payment system, so that's Faster Payments in the UK, SEPA in Europe, through a set of APIs. And that enables other banks, e-money institutions, and corporates to have access to real-time faster payments. And that, again, transforms the model when you can integrate to us in a matter of a couple of weeks, and you're suddenly making payments across those payment rails.
Interesting. Well, coming from the United States, we're hearing a lot about open banking now.
Yes.
What does that mean to you, and what is that going to mean to financial institutions and their customers?
That's a very simple question, but a very long answer. I think there's a whole range of different things. One of them is just that whole concept of being connected, integrating with other parties.
Right.
So that may mean that we're integrating through our marketplace, or people integrating on top of us. So account aggregation services like a Yolt and people like that can then access our customer data, and I think that's important. In terms of open banking and PSD2, I don't think we yet know where this is going to go.
Right.
I don't think we have got what I call the killer application. We haven't yet, as an industry, found this is amazing, this is exactly going to transform the world. I think we've got some great building blocks in the industry, and certainly Starling Bank has got some great building blocks and APIs. However, I think we're still waiting for the magic to occur of the, wow, this is just the amazing app. At the moment, it's very focused around account aggregation and therefore summarizing your accounts across a number of banks. I think there's a lot more that's going to happen. I just don't know what it is yet.
Oh, great. Well, lastly, what has stood out to you the most so far at Finovate Europe?
So I've been to Finovate many, many times over the years here. I think what is good is just seeing what the trends are. So in the last couple of years, it was very much around payments. This year seems a bit more broader. AI is key. I think a lot of KYC and AML solutions have been demoed, as well as some things in the payment space. So I think it's just a great opportunity to see leading edge technologies and people doing some interesting stuff.
Fantastic. Well, we really appreciate your time. And again, this is William Mills with Julian Sawyer at Finovate Europe.